I do not speak with heathen souls such as yourself. Okay. Well, in that case... Seriously? You screwball. I'm a screwball. Should have talked to me. What can I tell you? I'm not playing around here, guy. Laser pistol. Funny he didn't attack, though, with the lieutenant. The good lieutenant. Let's see what's in this locker. Okay. Dynamite. And more stim packs. Hmm. So weird. I wonder if it was the FEV desk. '73, something like that. Mach 4 computer. As usual, I can't seem to do anything with those. Oh, I meant to hit science. Nope, alright. Okay, then nothing here. Continuing on. Getting hurt. Oh, I have 115 hit points now? Oh, I went up to a new level. Whoop. Didn't even know that. Let's increase my throwing even more. Some throwing stuff. Oh, I'm at 101%. See, someone told me that after 100%, really, you don't hardly get anything. Like, they're very... It's much smaller improvement. I mean, I don't know. I'll increase it anyway. Repair, actually. Okay. Now let's save our changes here. Okay. Would think you repair these. They're not broken. You enable the force field emitter? Okay, good. You wouldn't kill an unarmed man, would you? Join us. Don't fight us. Huh. Children of the Cathedral Technician. What? He was hit for 167 hit points and was killed. You killed the right hand of God. The Master will be most upset. Now it has come time for us to join the Holy Flame. Seriously? Oh, I took robes. A green screen display monitor showing various bits of data. A few bytes occasionally show up. These guys are all going to kill themselves when I get close to them, aren't I? Well, they might have something useful. Oh, Or just rope. What is this? Laser pistol. The ones that say regular computer, looks like I might be able to do something with them. I surrender. If you don't surrender, you kill yourself. You're unable to get any useful information out of it. Security card. I got another. Okay, so it's a duplicate one. Alright. They're all just killing themselves off. Okay. Another security card. I got three of them now. Regular computer, computer. Vats Control Computer. This is where... Vats. A complex of some sort. You are not sure, but you can see large green vats of a greenish goo that looks vaguely important. This whole area. Alright, I guess this is where Lou was gonna dip me in. No matter what I point at, it just says vats. Even the window says vats. I'm gonna science some of this stuff. Maybe I'm supposed to use a security card on the computer. So I can't even tell what these computers are for. You manipulate the computer, and a moment later it sparks once and then shuts down. Looks like it's still running to me. Hmm. Am I supposed to shut them both down? Security card. I wasn't using it on that. I was trying to use it here. No, I only try to use it there for some reason. You managed to get an interface screen out of the VATS control computer. Well, where is it? Oh, cool. The machine whirs and clicks, followed by a loud beep. Access granted. Command? Hmm. Search logs. Specify log you'd like to review. Gray. Download log of Richard Gray? Yes. Command completed successfully. Boyarsky. Leonard Boyarsky? He's like one of the, part of the development team. He was the producer. Error. Unexpected end of line. Bad data encountered. Okay, there's a little Easter egg thrown in. Search logs, Maxson. Download log of Captain Maxson? Yes. Okay, search logs, Anderson. Unexpected end of line, bad data encountered. Like Richard Dean Anderson, maybe? We have other options, display security codes. uplink to medical computers. Set base to alert status. Set base to alert status and disable console or deactivate the base's alarms. Let's exit for now and take a look at these. Hopefully they'll be in here. Okay. Really? Richard Gray audio diary. Captain Maxson's diary. And what was the other one? Maxson's log. Let's hear Richard Gray. Is it an audio diary? No. It's one of me. It's audio because I'm going to read it. One of four, huh? So we got 0000 to 0004. I'm dying. I need to get this down before the pain overwhelms me. 5 to 20. I can't believe that I was able to... Finally, at least seconds, I guess? I can't believe I was finally able to drag myself out of that vat. The slime did not affect me, but I nearly drowned. I don't know what happened to Harold. He was standing right next to me when the crane knocked me into the vat. He must have been killed, or he would have tried to help me. Francine is dead, killed by one of those robots. Harold. 21 to 27. I have no idea how much time has passed. I was able to hack the... Oh! Harold! The mutant! The mutant from, what do you call it? The hub. And it wasn't killed. Okay, 21 to 27. I have no idea how much time has passed. I was able to hack the computer to turn off the robots and record this, but now my mind is slipping away. There is much pain. 28 to 43. The green slime that I was immersed in is the source of all the mutations we trace to here. My skin is... beginning, I guess, to fester and peel. In other areas, it is bubbling and starting to expel a green mucus-like substance. Some days the pain is almost tolerable. This is having trouble talking using correct grammar. 44 to 57. I can actually walk a few steps again. It seems inconceivable, that I drag myself all the way up here from the vat room. Strangely, I'm actually feeling stronger, although I'm still in a lot of pain. Everything seems to be getting smaller. I know, my friend, you're getting bigger. 58 to 96. Is that his name, Lewis Anderson? Wait, this is Richard Gray. I'm talking about Lou. Sergeant Lou. I think I consumed one of the mutated things scurrying... This is 58 through 96. One of the mutated things scurrying around here today. Before I knew what was happening, some sort of tendril had sprung from my stomach and covered the poor creature. As soon as it had sucked the rodent into my gut, I could actually feel its mind. I think. There is the very real possibility that I'm going slowly insane and can no longer differentiate between what is real and what is a hallucination. Maybe I'm still slowly dying in that vat and I've imagined all this. But you're also recording it into an audio log inside the vat. Before you know, you're not recording a log. Yeah, I get it. 97 to 111. Things are becoming more clear to me every day. This toxin has actually improved my mind. I feel that I can understand even the most complex philosophical questions simply and directly. It's as if all the layers of artifice have been stripped away. I wonder what would happen if I submerged an animal in the vats for a prolonged period of time. Would it gain awareness? 112 to 134. The strangest thing is happening to the animals. They're actually becoming smarter. I guess he did it. They're actually becoming smarter and more aware of their surroundings. I dipped a dog and a rat of the same... at the same time today, and they were fused together. It's not quite two creatures anymore, but it's more than one. Oh, like that thing from the movie The Thing that we find out there. Those weird floater things. Perhaps this is the future, a coming together of different creatures in some sort of harmonious unity. I no longer consume the different amounts of animals I create simply for sustenance. I have become the instrument through which unity will be achieved. I am so much more than a human being now. Oh, so I guess this is the guy who becomes the master. 135 to 139. It is time to bring others into the glory that is the unity. 140 to 153. A lost soul has finally strayed into my home. I was so surprised I consumed him before dipping, a mistake I shall not make again, his mind was so primitive as to be repulsive to my refined cognitive abilities. 154 to 172. I've begun to modify myself to be more pleasing to the Unity by injecting small doses of the virus into my body. The slime in the vats is a man-made virus called the Forced Evolutionary Virus. This information was acquired from my newly grown Neuralink with the base computer. 173 to 198. The few wanderers that have found their way here have been a disappointment to me. They can't seem to mutate correctly. The best I've been able to create are some big and dumb mutants. Most can recall nothing from before I initiated them into the wondrous Unity. I only feed on them for fuel now. Their minds are nothing to me. 199 to 236. O glorious creator, I have succeeded in spreading the complete joy of unification to another soul. Unlike the others, his total radiation count was low. I believe this is the factor we have been overlooking all this time, as it seems the conversion is more successful in the cases with less radiation damage. I have never known such glory as I felt when taking his mind into our own. 237 to 281. We are beginning to create an army dedicated to unifying the wonderful diversity of life. We have trained them to continue our work here while we search out more populated areas to take into ourselves. We are beginning to feel the limitations of a body that is mobile. We must find a permanent home with a greater store of knowledge and a steady supply of biomass. 282 to 383. Or 303, I think. We have stopped increasing ourselves until we can find this new unification center. When we have arrived, we will continue to grow and feed until we have brought peace and unity to the whole world. Yeah, you go to the children of the cathedral to do that. Okay. Maxson's log. One of two. He also has a diary. By my orders, as active commanding officer followed the untimely death of Captain Robert Spindell, during this time of crisis, the full base security team has been deployed to the security bunker at Lost Hills. This directive also includes the families of the officers and enlisted men. Unless otherwise directed from a proper representative of the War Department, this order will stand as written. Operative 1. All military personnel and their families are to vacate the base by 0800 25 October 2077. All personnel traveling under command will make their way to Lost Hills Base. Did I read this one already? I don't know. No leave has been granted. Operative 2. All civilian personnel are directed to remain at base pending orders from their legal command structure. Operative 3. Equipment deemed necessary to the survival of base military personnel is to be immediately drawn from stores. Proper authorization will follow, time permitting. Operative 4. All codes of military justice will be harshly enforced on military personnel and civilian personnel in joint military operations. Operative 5. Until such time as consistent and authorized communication can be established with the War Department, these orders will have precedence over my previously established orders. Captain Maxson, 24 October 2077. I mean, if I already read this stuff, it's good to, you know, review it at this point, I guess. Captain Maxson's diary. One of three. October 10th, 2077. I, Roger Maxson, Captain, serial number, blah, 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 have started this log because it doesn't look good for any of us, and I'd like for people to know what really happened here. All hell broke loose when we finally discovered what those scientist bastards were up to. The colonel has locked himself in his office and seems to be having some sort of breakdown. The men are screaming for blood. They're looking to me for answers, and I'm not sure what to do. Someone has to do something, though, before this place sinks into an anarchistic bloodbath. October 12th, 2 days later. Every time we get a report from higher up, things get worse here. The war is going in a very bad direction, and this place is about to go into full mutiny with all the chaos that entails. I stopped one of the men from executing a scientist today and demanded that we interrogate them to find out what their orders were. Next day, October 13th, I killed a man today. I was interrogating Chief Scientist Anderson and was giving me the full details of their inhuman experiments. He said his orders came from the government, but I didn't buy it. He started screaming about how he was following orders, how he was a military man, and I just shot him. I kept telling myself it was to keep him from causing a full mutiny among the men, but I'm not so sure. Now, he must have shot him and he fell into the vat. Oh, the crane knocked him into the vat. Well, that's Gray, not Anderson. Okay, so it's not Richard Dean Anderson, it's... It's Anderson, Chief Scientist Anderson. Sorry guys, I'm getting the names mixed up. Okay, October 15th, 2 days later. I tried again to speak to the colonel through the door. That's Lou, guy I just killed. But he seems to have completely lost touch with reality. I broke down the door with several of the men just in time to watch him blow his head off. Right before he pulled the trigger, he said he was sorry. Oh, maybe not the same colonel, lieutenant. October 18th, which is 3 days later. By killing the egghead, I seem to have confirmed my position as leader of the men. They follow me without question now. The interrogations invariably end up being executions. Shellman held out the longest, but the end result was the same. Her arguments about her orders were a bit specific to be completely made up. I'm getting a real bad feeling in my gut about how this is all going to end up. I don't even lie to myself anymore about my reasons for executing the scientists. October 20th, 2 days later. I finally replied to the outside world over our radio. I don't know why they never sent anyone here to see what was happening when we stopped responding to their transmissions. Doesn't make any sense. Well, they'll come now. I declared ourselves seceded from the Union. They remember Jefferson Davis. What will history say about me? October 22nd, 2 days later. What the hell is going on? We declare ourselves to be in full desertion from the Army and no longer under the government's command, and what happens? Nothing. Something bad is coming down. Sorry, guys. Hair is in the way. October 23rd. Next day. I can't believe these bastards finally did it. Damn them all to hell. Damn you all to hell. They finally let the A-bombs fly. We're right in the middle of trying to pry the real story out of Von Felden when we completely lost contact. I have a feeling the research center was hit hard. I don't know why. Just going out of gut feeling. It seems inconceivable, is that word again, that we were not targeted. I'm sure China will make up for that oversight real soon. Luckily, we had moved our families from outside into the facility the day before yesterday. We do not yet know if the fallout has reached this area. October 25th, which is 2 days later. Sergeant Plattner volunteered to go outside today to take specific readings on the atmosphere. It seems the radiation has not spread this far. Since he was wearing his power armor, there was no threat to him from radiation, but if he had been exposed, he would have to be exiled. We don't have adequate decontamination facilities here. Next day, October 26th, I convinced the men that we should bury the scientists. I don't know why. Perhaps it was to ease my conscience. I finally decided to believe their stories when the last one was dying. My God, what have I become? October 27th, we're leaving this godforsaken place today. I'm leading the exodus to the old government bunker at Lost Hills. I'm leaving this log behind to be buried when this place goes in the next exchange. Who knows, maybe someone will find it someday. Yeah, someone found it. Okay. Look at this one monitor. Not on. Yeah. So I'll see if I can get more of the screens on. Alright, let's save. Since I don't know what's gonna happen here. So Biarski doesn't work. Anderson doesn't work. What a shame. Display security codes. Attempt to hack through the firewall to get more data. Display security code encryption table. Executing command. Oh, that's one of them. Wait. We can, just in case we can't hack it right. Hold on, I'm trying to find a thing of paper that I can write on that I haven't not already used. This goes with that. Hold on. I'm gonna write this down. At least some of it. Yeah, I'll write it all down. Who knows? I didn't get a look at the other codes. 536475-69, dudes. 626568B. Oh. 626. Six B is turn off alarms. So we know what that code does. Interesting how this is an activate instead. I really don't want to do this. So this is one of the security codes. Oh no. Nope. It's not even. Nope. Alright. I thought I could eliminate one of them. Never mind. Uplink to medical computers. Uplink successful. What is your command? What is the current status of the patients? Current status of patients on patients as follows. FEV batch number 23872A consists of 4 male units and 2 female units. All individuals suffering from FEV exposure. Vital signs are within normal parameters. FEV process on all subjects is approximately 50% complete. Expect a full FEV transformation within 12 hours. Patients suffering arrhythmia. Display patient status logs. Status report on individual patients. Shut down life support. Or increased dosage. Let's get status report first. I'm not going to shut down life support. Please enter authorization code. Attempt to hack the computer, I guess. Otherwise I'm just blindly... Authorization code accepted. Please stand by. Accessing data. Ready to process request. Increase original DNA strand dosage to 100% on all subjects. I think that would reverse the effects. Are you sure you wish to increase the dosage? Auto-correction will be disabled if you do this. Yes. Increasing dosage of original DNA 200%. Warning. Auto correction has been disabled. I don't know why it says suffering arrhythmia. And yet we can't get... weird. We can't get status on all... It just goes right to the other two. I think something is happening to one of the patients. Is there anything I can do? Status report. See, when I do status report, it just shows these two. Authorization code accepted. And that's just a total. I'm not increasing by 100% every time. It's just a total of... Attempt to hack through the firewall to get more data. Display security code encryption table. Oh, wait. I have something. Data already exists, but yet it's not here. I don't see anything. I also have this other one. Zero 10597. I don't know if that's anything. I love that sound. So classic. You have successfully hacked into the encryption table. Command. Oh, really? Silent self-destruct in 1 minute. Self-destruct in 1 minute. Activate alarms and disable console. Silent self-destruct in 5 minutes. 3 minutes. Immediate self-destruct sequence. That would be a bad idea. What's the difference between silent self-destruct and self-destruct? I can silent self-destruct in 5 or 10 minutes. I can self-destruct in 3 or 5 minutes. I guess silent, it doesn't tell you how much time you have left. I should really get out of here in 5 minutes, right? Executing 110, blah, 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 blah. Okay, it's telling me how many seconds. Let's get the hell out of here. Back to the elevator. Don't stop. What the hell?